Hi guys, I'm glad you're here with me today. Thank you. Please subscribe, like, and share my videos. We have an asteroid that's going to go by our planet on January 15th. Of course, the gravity of the Earth could actually pull it in. It's going to be 440,000 miles, I guess. It says MI. Above the Earth's crust, and it's 22 feet across. It's kind of one of these dinky little asteroids. 2023 AH. This is where it's currently at, according to skylive.com. And you supposedly can see it in the southern hemisphere as it comes closer and closer to the Earth. Yeah, so if it's 2 days out, and supposedly you can see it if you got binoculars or maybe a telescope. Yeah, I wonder, is it really only 22 feet across? Here it says visibility right now. 2023 AH is just above the horizon from Greenwich, United Kingdom. It is visible looking at the south-southeast direction at an altitude of 37 above the horizon. Given the current magnitude, it is visible only through long exposure photography. Oh, okay, I was wrong about the telescope. I wonder how fast this thing is flying, because right now, from the distance to the sun, it is 147.76 million kilometers. From the Earth, it is 0.95 million kilometers. I did find this thing called Neil.fun. And what it is an asteroid impact little game you can play. So let me launch another asteroid. And I'll give you a link. It'll be down below 20 feet. Okay. I'll put it at 71,000 miles an hour. It's probably moving faster than that. And impact angle. And let's just put it right there. Long Island, New York. And we'll launch. Let me pull this down. And we'll launch the asteroid and see what happens. It says it would be an airburst that blew up 18 miles above the ground. The explosion was equivalent to 70 kilotons of TNT. An impact of this size happens about every 14 years. So, yeah, it's a dinky, tiny little asteroid. But, yeah, something to think about. There's another one that's larger coming in June. Before I go there, I'll show you this, which is showing you where the asteroid is out. I'm going to try and make that larger. Yeah, I wish I could zoom in larger, but yeah, I can't. Let me pull this up. I wonder if I can twist it around. It's going to be so darn close to the Earth. Yeah, it just won't let me zoom in closer. Here on CNET.com, it says another space rock is in our relative neighborhood and has a tiny chance of actually impacting the Earth, or our atmosphere at least. Maybe another airburst. The asteroid 2016 LP10 has been on astronomers' radar for several years now. It's on the European Space Agency risk list with about 1 in 9,000 chance of impact on June 10th. There is little reason for concern, though, as it is estimated to be only 4 meters 13 feet across, which should burn up almost completely before it reaches the surface. So here we have a list of the current risk close approaches, NEOs. So this is the one here that will hopefully fly by or just be an airburst and blow out all the windows. It says the 15th. Which would be Sunday. Let's see, they got another one that's going to be a little bit closer. January 20th, 20 BP. That one's between 19 and 43 meters across. So that would be about 400 feet across. It's traveling about 38,000 miles per hour. And let's pick a site for impact. And we'll launch our asteroid and see what it does. Holy cow. 1.9 mile crater. Wow. An estimated 1,474 people would have been vaporized in the crater. The crater is 2,169 feet deep. And your asteroid impacted the ground at, 122 miles per hour. The same equivalent of 170 megatons of TNT. Wow. And that one's coming on January 20th. Let's see. Let's view, on JPL, the, orbit viewer. Oh, but it's going to be way out there. Yeah. There we got Earth. Oh, no. Okay. There's the Earth. There's the moon. Let's see. Can I go out farther? Oh, this is a different little thing that they're showing me. Yeah. Let's see. What does it show down here? Okay. Okay. That one's much farther out. It is 5.19 lunar distance from the Earth. And yeah, I think we're safe from that one, thank God. Yeah. If you want to take the time and look at these, there's several pages of near-Earth asteroids and the different dates. This page goes up to January 26th. And then the next page would be to February 14th. And then the next page would be, let's see, March. And you can go on and on. See which ones might be coming close this year. I'm sure they're going to update it. At least I hope they do when they find new asteroids. Let's see here. Let me go down here. Oh, fireball. It says that would create a fireball. 2.2 mile fireball. On an estimated 287,000 people would die from the fireball. Wow. Boy, I can almost smell that. Clothes would catch on fire within 6.8 miles of the impact. Trees would catch on fire within 15 miles of the impact. Shockwave. Holy cow. Wow. Wow. Yeah, what else does it have on here? Anyone within 8.6 miles would likely have ruptured eardrums. Buildings within 15 miles would collapse. Homes within 20 miles would collapse. Wind speeds, 6.313 miles per hour. I got a lot of information on this one. Winds within 4.5 miles would be faster than storms on Jupiter. Homes within 7.3 miles would be completely leveled. Within 13 miles, it would feel like being inside a EF5 tornado. Nearly all trees within 22 miles would be knocked down. Be the same as a 5.9 earthquake. An estimated 760 people would die from that earthquake. The earthquake would be felt as far as 28 miles away. Wow. All right, so let me bring this out and see how we different areas where we can put this. Maybe you want to set it on top of your ex-husband or ex-wife or ex-boyfriend or ex-girlfriend's house. Let's see. Let's put it up by the Great Lakes. What would happen if, in the middle of Lake Michigan? All right, let's launch it. Okay. Let's see. Would it have calculated for the water? More energy released than the eruption of Krakatoa in 1883. An impact this size happens on an average of every 7,000 years. A 2.5 mile wide fireball. Let's see how. Let's bring that out so I can see how much of the water would be vaporized. Let's see. Okay. Let me go down a little bit farther. Okay, this here is a shock wave. Yeah, that would probably create a tsunami, I imagine. This is really interesting. Wind speeds. Don't have to worry about. I wonder how about people along the shoreline for the earthquake. This is a magnitude, 5.0 on the outside. And that's all they got. Yeah, this is kind of a cool little warp sense of humor for a game. Yeah, I'll give you a link. It'll be down below in the box below the video. More information. Many of you have on your tablets probably can't see it, but it says NEAL.FUN/asteroid -launcher and then another little sign. Yeah, so what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Always be prepared for a disaster. Yeah, this one's coming in June. What can I say? Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your support, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.